Hey guys, it's Vinda. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Since many of you guys have asked me how I edit my artworks and maintain my wide field, so I decided to take you guys along a detailed process in which I'll show you how I click the pictures and edit them using my phone. This is how my wide Instagram feed looks like. If you don't follow me on Instagram, check out my page at Beyond Vinda. So without further ado, let's get right into the video. So I'll start with the basics, capturing my artworks. I try to place my artworks in such a place where I can get even lighting over them. I would recommend you guys the same and also advise you not to click pictures in direct sunlight as it creates harsh shadows and it gets really annoying to get rid of them while editing. I click pictures in square mode in camera. Also, if you're using any art supplies for your flat lays, try to keep them parallel to each other so they look organized rather than messy. I use a white sheet as a backdrop and then lay all the supplies and my artwork on it. Also, click multiple shots from different angles so that you can choose from them later. So now, we are moving on to the editing part. In this video, I'm going to show you how I edit my pictures using my phone. This is the easiest method and you'll need only one app, that's Snapseed. So after importing your image in Snapseed, the first thing I do is edit the perspective of the image to make it look straight and then I crop it accordingly. Then I choose the brush option and that's where the magic begins. I use the exposure to +1.0 and cover the entire area with it. Look how beautifully the picture has turned out. If you feel like that the color of your artwork has faded a bit, you can lower the exposure, that is 0.7, and then go over your artwork again and you will be good to go. If you are still not happy with the color of your background, you can go over it again with a 0.7 exposure and highlight the art supplies and artworks with 0.3 exposure so it all looks natural. This is how the before and after looks like. We edited this by using the brush tool and the perspective tool. If you're happy with your image, you can export it and now you have a perfect white background. If you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching and supporting, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!